Hello and welcome again. We could not complete the subject aromaticity in one lecture. So we had to split into two parts. In this lecture, we will be doing the second part of aromaticity. That means we'll discuss about anti-aromaticity and non-aromaticity. Now, just like in a lighter vein, in a lighter note, just like we have three terms coined with social behavior. That is, he is a social person, he is an antisocial person, he is an unsocial person. Social means very, very friendly, very, very talkative, all are in lighter vein. Gossip mongering, very socializing, friendly. So that is aromatic, for example, is very stable. Gossip mongers are very stable and inert. And the opposite of social is antisocial. They are enemies of the society, thieves, burglars. They are opposite of social. Similarly, anti-aromatics are opposite of aromatics. They are unstable, highly unstable. And unsocial is neither friendly, not they are antisocial. They are not dacoits, they are not enemies of the society. They are unsocial, they don't make friends much. They are intermediate between, not intermediate, they are not as unstable as anti-aromatics, not as stable like aromatics. They are intermediate. Similarly, we had seen the Hockel's rule of aromaticity. Do you remember what are the three requirements for a species to be called aromatic? It should be planar, all the atoms are sp2 hybridized, planar and cyclic, and it should have 4n plus 2 conjugating peripheral pi electrons. Peripheral means it should encircle a complete loop, a continuous loop or ring, peripheral pi electrons. So today we shall be looking at the same Hockel's rule extended to identify which are anti-aromatics, opposite of aromatics. They should be cyclic, similar to aromaticity. They should be planar or nearly planar, similar to aromaticity, but the difference is the number of conjugating, let me not coin the term conjugating. 4n number of pi bonds, alternate pi bonds, 4n, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3, cannot be 0. Must be having some pi electrons. If it is 0, then no pi electrons, so it starts from 1. 4n alternate pi bonds. I am not writing here conjugating pi electrons. They do not really conjugate. We will talk about that just after a bit. They have even number of, just like in the case of aromaticity, I told you the trick how to remember odd number of pi electron pairs, conjugating pairs. Here, even number of alternate pi electron pairs. 2 means 4 pi electrons. 4 pairs means 8 pi electrons, 6 pairs means 12 pi electrons. So these are the number of pi electrons which are there in a conjugating style, in a conjugating mode, but ironically, they do not conjugate. They do not conjugate. But the style is conjugating, right? Now see, let me bring my pen, my thick pen, yes. The unique feature of anti-aromatics, let me read out once again, they are unusually, exceptionally unstable compared to their cyclic analogs. While aromatic compounds are stable compared to their acyclic counterparts, the anti-aromatics, they are the anilines, cyclic compounds, sometimes ionic species, but they are unstable, highly unstable, to the extent some of them do not exist. They are very reactive. Those which are possible, to exist, but they exist at a very low temperature, sub-zero temperature, and they are highly reactive at ordinary temperature. Cyclobutadiene, the classic and the simplest example of anti-aromatic, is cyclobutadiene. Dimerizes easily at room temperature. You cannot bring cyclobutadiene to room temperature. You have to stabilize only below 35 Kelvin, that is minus 238 degrees Celsius. Then you can keep store cyclobutadiene. But the moment you raise the temperature, they react with themselves. Two of them dimerize to form a dimer. I'm not showing the reaction of that dimerization. Now the pi bonds are found to be localized. It's not delocalized. The style is alternate double bond, single bond, so it looks like it is conjugating the resonance. There is no resonance. So resonance theory is absolutely silent in case of anti-aromatics. The only respite comes from molecular orbital theory, which explains the unusual instability of this anti-aromatic species. Now, let us take some examples. This cyclobutadiene, now the double bonds are not conjugating, they are localized to the extent that the shape is not square planar, it is rectangular planar, so that this localized double bonds are of shorter length and the single bonds are of longer length. So it is rectangular in shape, not square, and it is stable below 35 Kelvin. Cyclopropanoid ion, two electrons. Cyclopropanilium ion was aromatic, two pi electron. This is four pi electron. And this is unstable. This is just for academic excitement. It is not prepared, or it cannot be prepared. But yes, theoretically, if you prepare, it is very, very unstable and it is anti-aromatic. This also is a bookkeeping species. Cyclopentadienylium ion, this is plus, not dienide. Had it been minus, then 6 aromatic. That can be prepared easily. But this cannot be prepared easily, or sometimes not possible. Just an academic exercise, excitement. Cyclopentadienylium ion, this is 4 pi electrons. 4 pi electrons means anti-aromatic. 4, 8, multiples of 4, 2 pairs, 4 pairs, even number of pairs, 4 pairs, then 8 pairs, then 6 pairs, 4 after that, 6, then 8. Then another example of anti-aromatics having 8 pi electrons is cyclohepta-trienide ion. Trienylium ion was aromatic, tropylium ion. Cycloheptatrienylium ion is famously called tropylium ion, that is aromatic. But this is cycloheptatrienide ion, which is having eight so-called conjugating pi electrons. There is no conjugation. So-called conjugation means it looks like as if a great amount of resonance is occurring here, so it is highly stable. No, this is highly unstable. Such a species is seldom produced. Similarly, this is a produced. Pentaline is an anti-aromatic species which is very unstable and is stable only below minus 100 degrees Celsius. And some of other examples of theoretical interest. Cyclopentadienylium ion, already discussed. This is oxirene. You remember, I don't think you have studied the chemistry of alkenes. If not, forget about. It's just here in one ear and expel in the other ear. Promise. Supposing you take alkene and add with oxygen or some peroxy compound, metaperoxy benzoic acid. So you get a epoxy compound, that is alkene oxide, or it is called oxyrrhene, epoxidation of alkene. If you try to do same thing with alkyne, it will never happen. Alkyne will not be epoxidized like this by any peroxy compound, peroxy acid. So this is a non-entity. Just for a fun, we are discussing oxyrrhene doesn't exist. You cannot prepare oxyrrhene. Yes, trace of oxyrrhene has been prepared for theoretical interest. It's very unstable, maybe stable nearing absolute zero, right? Similarly, azurine is okay. So alkyne bonding with a nitrine is impossible, because they're all anti-aromatic in look, in its structure, cannot be prepared easily. Cyclobutadiene, yes, it can be prepared, but can be stored below 35 Kelvin, otherwise it will undergo dimerization. Similarly, pentylene is stable below minus 100 degree Celsius. Now see, just for fun, because I presume that you have not studied the chemistry of the SN1 reaction. Supposing you are carrying out the substitution reaction where you are taking cyclopentyl iodide and you are hydrolyzing it, adding water. So I minus will go to form a carbocation in the first step, which is slow and redetermining. I forget about if you cannot understand what is the meaning of redetermining. Slow step, forget. Now this is a carbocation, 2 degree carbocation, that you will understand, a 2 degree carbocation, which is moderately stable. And therefore, the second step occurs, you know, the nucleophile attacks, then deprotonation leads to cyclopentanol. But cyclopentadienyl iodide, iodine bonded to cyclopentadiene ring, will never ever undergo such SN1 reaction. You can't get cyclopentadienol, never formed. This is a theoretical exercise. Academic exercise. Had it been formed, then I minus would have gone to produce a very unstable carbocation, that is cyclopentadienylium ion, which is anti-aromatic, 4 pi electrons, right? And a so-called conjugating system, right? It looks like a conjugating system. We'll talk about molecular orbital theory very soon. So resonance, this is fake resonance. Such compound you may think is allyl carbocation on both the sides. You can draw RSS, yes, you'll be happy. You can draw BBT, can be applied to draw two more RSS resonance structures, but of no use. It doesn't stabilize this because of anti-aromaticity, which can only be explained by MOT. This is highly unstable, anti-aromatic, no real resonance happening here. These are localized. And therefore, such a product is not possible, never formed. Got it? Interesting? Okay. Then we will take some examples where there will be 12 pi electrons, N is equal to 3, 12 pi electrons, anti-aromatics. Classic example is S-indacene. This is a tri-substituted trialkyl S-indacene. S-indacene is the ring, only this six-membered ring fused with 2 5-membered rings, and the number of pi electrons is 12, and it is planar, and because of planarity and having 4n pi electrons, so-called conjugating pi electrons, it is anti-aromatic. In fact, it is highly unstable, but it can be stored at a low temperature. But if you convert it to its dianion, just 2 lithium, it will, you know, give 2 extra electrons from lithium, and it will form dianion 2-. That fortunately will become having 14 pi electrons, and it is showing stability. Unlike this, this is highly stable. It shows aromatic character. This has 12 pi electrons. Although being planar, it is unstable, anti-aromatic. This is 14 pi electrons, which is aromatic. See the dramatic change by accepting 2 electrons. An anti-aromatic species is converted to aromatic species. Now this is called biphenylene. two benzene rings connected by two single bonds. Now, if you count the number of pi electrons, you will be tempted to call it anti-aromatic. 6 plus 6, 12. Yes, in the earlier time when anti-aromaticity was, the concept was developed. Yes, by phenylene was declared to be anti-aromatic. But subsequently, it was found that it is aromatic. It is very close to polyaromatic, that is naphthalene. But aromaticity is greatly reduced because of the presence of this 4-electron cyclobutadiene ring in the middle. The aromaticity, the conjugation is reduced, but it is to be taken as two independent benzene rings, aromatic. But it was previously considered to be anti-aromatic because of 8 electrons. But here, that is not much conjugation. There might be a little bit of conjugation, but not much conjugation. That is why this is a single bond character, 1.52 angstrom, and these are 1.4 angstroms, like benzene. So, in many literature, you will find biphenylene as anti-aromatic, but actually it is aromatic, right? It is stable. You can store it at room temperature as a solid compound. Now, coming to exceptional examples of anti-aromatic. This is cyclopentadienone. Because of the contribution of this particular, resonance structure, which is anti-aromatic. Of course, the contribution is less because it is unstable. And therefore, because of some anti-aromatic character present in this compound, it can easily dimerize. It's not stable and it can easily dimerize by Diels-Alder reaction. We'll not talk about Diels-Alder reaction. If we do so, then what we will do in the subsequent videos, where I'll be discussing each name reaction in a separate manner, in a very extensive manner. So it undergoes easy dimerization because it has some anti-aromatic character. Now, this is for fun. This is for fun, simply for fun. Porphyrin rings, these are macrocyclic, as well as heterocyclic rings. So many nitrogen, 4 nitrogen, so tetra. Here there are 5 nitrogen penta. So these are the polydentate ligands used in biomolecules, biopolymers, biomolecules like hemoglobin, hemi, and all that, like chlorophyll. So these are the compounds, macrocyclic ligands, which contains 4 amino groups or 5 amino groups, like this. But let me tell you that not all pi bonds are counted. It has to be covering a loop, a peripheral loop. So you have to bypass if that particular pi bond does not fall into a closed loop. For example, here, this pi bond has to be ignored. Because if you go by this, then you have to ignore this. You have to make a periphery. If you make this periphery, you have to ignore this. This double bond will be ignored. But nitrogen, since it is the donor, of course, nitrogen lone pair is not taking part. It is the pi bond, carbon nitrogen pi bond, which is taking place, not the lone pair. But nitrogen should be included in the loop. That is why we neglected this and this. So we count only 18. Although there are 22 pi electrons, but we take at least an 18 belonging to the aromatic, 4n plus 2, n is equal to 4. So this is aromatic. This is called porphyrin is aromatic. So also this related compound, this is called porphycin. It is also 18 aromatic. This is excluded from counting the number of conjugating pi electrons. Very similar type, but the difference is here. You find here there is one extra atom is here, and there is no extra atom, is directly connected. Now this is different. Oxidized porphyrin. This oxidized to give this. There, these four pi bonds are neglected. They are not considered as a part of the loop, closed cycle. Now this, because this nitrogen double bond is taken, this taken. So the outer pi bonds are not considered belonging to the closed peripheral loop. So it comes to 16, and 16 is 4N. This is anti-aromatic. Again, this is anti-aromatic. This is anti-aromatic. The blue colored ones are anti-aromatic. You can well imagine which have been deleted, not counted for counting the number of pi electrons which are conjugating really, or so-called conjugating to make it an anti-aromatic compound. Here also this is 22 pi electrons and 4N plus 2, if N is equal to 5, 5 fours are 20 plus 2, 22 pi electrons, conjugating pi electrons make it aromatic. So this is sapphirin is aromatic. Smaragdirin is also aromatic. So also isosmaragdirin is 22 22 22, and orangarin, that is anti-aromatic. And these two pi bonds are not considered, coming under 20, that is even number of pairs, 10 pairs. 20 is 4N, N is equal to 10, sorry, N is equal to 5, so 20 pi electrons is anti-aromatic. So this is all discussed for fun. The red ones are aromatic, the blue ones are anti-aromatic. Now coming to non-aromatic, three things I gave an analogy, a vague analogy I gave, that is social, unsocial and antisocial. If social is we consider it stable, that is aromatic, then unsocial is non-aromatic, that we will be discussing now, and antisocial is anti-aromatic. So what is the intermediate? I mean, it should be a cyclic compound, an aniline. It has to be an aniline. If it is not a cyclic compound, then the term aromatic should not be coined, whether it is non or anti. Aromatic word has to be deleted. Has to be cyclic. It can have 4N pi electrons or 4N plus 2 pi electrons. I'm just reading it out with my big thick pen. Anilines containing both 4N plus 2 like aromatic, or 4N like anti-aromatic pi electrons, behaving similar to their acyclic analogs, neither aromatic nor anti-aromatic. Aromatics are stable, anti-aromatics are highly unstable, but they are as much stable as their acyclic counterparts. So they are behaving similar to acyclic analogs in stability and reactivity. They are called non-aromatics, non-aromatic compounds. Usually they are neutral compounds. There is hardly any positive or negative ion which belong to the non-aromatic category. This is due to absence of planarity, or some structural issues which prevent proper ring conjugation. The loop is not established among the conjugating electrons. If these two things are there, like the molecule lacks planarity, for example, in many higher member rings, more than 7, 8, 9, more than 7, even if there is alternate double bond, single bond, the ring cannot take planar conformation, structure. You know, the planarity will make it unstable to escape instability, to escape anti-aromatic behavior. It takes a puckering, or it is puckered, takes a three-dimensional shape by rotation about carbon-carbon single bonds. It becomes three-dimensional, goes away from planarity. The planarity is lost only to escape out of instability. Whenever there is a situation of foreign pi electrons comes, then it has to make it stable. It has to stabilize itself by going out of planarity. So this is due to a cyclo. This is the classic example is cyclooctatetraene. So from a look, you may consider that 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, there are 8 pi electrons. So you declare it to be anti-aromatic, but actually it is stable. Not as much stable as aromatic, but it is stable like an acyclic counterpart. It undergoes addition reactions like an acyclic diene or triene or tetraene. And no substitution, doesn't undergo substitution reaction easily like aromatic compound. So shows all properties of an acyclic conjugated polyene. So this is called non-aromatic. You must be very cautious. A non-aromatic compound can look like an aromatic compound or an anti-aromatic compound, usually anti-aromatic compound, because once it is aromatic, it is stable. But it is not anti-aromatic because it is not planar. For you know, even for MOT that we will explain, the planarity is required because of the overlapping of different p orbitals to produce multiple molecular orbitals. They also have to remain in one plane. Now, actually, the shape of cyclooctatetraene is not planar. It is top-shaped like this. So that once there is no planarity, there is no so-called molecular orbital formation to explain its instability. So it is as much stable as any other acyclic counterpart. Similarly, I will take another few examples of non-aromatic compounds. Say this is a 10 aniline, cyclodecapentaene. Cyclodecapentaene is, you can call it 10 aniline because the number of carbon atoms is 10. So 10 aniline, alternate double bond, single bond. Actually, this should be anti-aromatic because 20 pi electrons. 10 pi electrons. This is 8 pi electrons and this is 10 pi electrons. Yes, 4n, n is equal to 10 means it is looking like aromatic. I'm sorry, I withdraw earlier statement that aromatic look but not remaining planar is hardly found, but yes, aromatic look means there are 10 pi electrons like naphthalene. Naphthalene is a bicyclic, but this is a monocyclic. So there are 10 pi electrons, but still, because large number of carbon atoms, there will be a lot of strain. Transannular strain, forget about transannular strain. So for that, it does not remain planar, it is puckered. It becomes three-dimensional by the rotation of several carbon-carbon single bonds. It acquires a real boat shape. And because of that, even if it looks like aromatic, it is non-aromatic. It behaves in a similar way as an acyclic polyene. Similarly, this 10 aniline has three stable isomers. This is all cis, all cis, which is a boat-like shape. But others also, trans cis, also there is a lot of transannular strain that makes the molecule go out of plane. Planarity is not there, so it is also non-aromatic. But look, this is non-aromatic, but the moment there is a connection between this carbon number 1 and carbon number 6, that becomes aromatic. Now see, if you connect between carbon 1 and 6, it becomes naphthalene and it is aromatic. Or if you give one more carbon atom, to make it a bicyclic compound, then also it is aromatic. But if it remains free, there is a lot of transannular strain, and to relieve that strain, these two have gone opposite to each other. They remaining trans. This hydrogen is remaining trans to each other. Only to relieve the transannular strain. Forget about transannular strain now. And there is another isomer, that is trans cis, that also remains, you know, this is a double bond here, and you know, that also is non-planar. Because of the non-planarity, they do not exhibit aromaticity. Here also, because of non-aromaticity, they do not exhibit anti-aromaticity. So this is non-aromatic, but the structure, the planar structure looks like anti-aromatic. Here the planar structure looks like aromatic, but actually they are non-planar and non-aromatic. That's it. Now see, this heptalene, seven membered rings fused together, this is heptalene, looks like 12 pi electrons, looks like anti-aromatic. In fact, earlier they were calling it anti-aromatic, but it is stable. Heptalene is stable and is non-planar. Heptalene is unstable like anti-aromatic, but it is non-planar. So you can consider it as anti-aromatic, also non-aromatic. Since it is non-planar, let us call it non-aromatic. But it is unstable. It has anti-aromatic character. But the moment you make its dianion by treating with lithium metal, then it has got 14 pi electrons, 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 plus 2 plus 2, 10, 2, 12, 2, 14, that becomes aromatic. The dianion of heptalene becomes aromatic, planar. This is non-planar, but this is planar. That's the beauty, and its properties studied. And other non-aromatic, see, this is cycloheptatriene. It's not trinilium ion, which is tropilium ion aromatic, or trionide ion, which is anti-aromatic, 8 pi electrons. It is trine. This is sp3. Up to this there is planarity, but the planarity is destroyed in this portion because it is sp3. So the entire loop, it doesn't remain in one plane and cannot go for a complete loop delocalization. So as if this is not there, it is simply hexatrine. Because of the intervening sp3 carbon, that non-planarity makes it non-aromatic. Looking like aromatic, 6 pi electrons, but because of the sp3 carbon, that makes it non-aromatic. It is as much reactive as normal polyene, acyclic polyene, and it doesn't undergo substitution reactions easily. Rather, it undergoes addition reactions easily. And its acid strength is very, very less. pK is 36. So rather, we can think of removing hydroiodine to make it a stable aromatic species, tropilium ion, and cannot lose a proton to form a cycloheptatrienide ion, which is anti-aromatic. You understand why the cycloheptatrienide ion is unstable? It's only a bookkeeping device, cycloheptatrienilium ion, which is a cation, tropilium ion, which is highly stable. And this one, because of the sp3 carbon here, sp3 carbon here, so the ring conjugation is not possible. The conjugation is up to this, 6 pi electrons, no doubt. This is sp2. So this is the conjugated part, but this part does not belong to the conjugation, so there is no loop. Cyclic loop is missing, so aromaticity is not there. Similarly, these pi bond are exocyclic. They are remaining outside the ring. So they cannot go for a complete loop delocalization. So the proper ring loop delocalization is missing out here, although it has 6 pi electrons. So also here, there is exocyclic double bond. the double bond is outside, so there is no 6 electron loop that will prevent its aromaticity. These are all non-aromatic. So also this is the, you know, dihydropentalene. Pentalene is anti-aromatic, but the moment you hydrogenate it, make it H2HCH2CH2, then it is non-aromatic. 6 pi electrons, but planarity is destroyed here, planarity is destroyed here. But the moment you treat it with butyl lithium, which is a strong base butyl carbanion, removes a proton here, removes a proton here, is a dianion, so it becomes 10 electrons. 10 pi electrons and becomes aromatic, like naphthalene, it becomes aromatic. The dianion from pentalene. Heptalene was non-aromatic, but its dianion was aromatic. Pentalene is anti-aromatic, but its dianion is also aromatic. Similarly, this compound, because it is sp3 cyclopentadiene derivative, CF3 is there, it is non-aromatic because it is sp3, planarity is destroyed. But looking like it is anti-aromatic, there are 4 pi electrons. The moment you treat it with a strong base, remove a proton, because this proton is highly acidic, this hydrogen is highly acidic, because the carbanion is highly stabilized by the minus I electron withdrawing effect of CF3, as well as the conjugation, the aromatic stabilization makes it aromatic, cyclopentadiene iodine. Now at the end, we will talk about the MOT approach. How molecular orbital theory, although it is not to be discussed in high school level, it is in the college level program, but I feel like telling to you in a very rudimentary way how we can explain the aromaticity and anti-aromaticity by using MOT approach. You know from chemical bond program what are molecular orbitals. Atomic orbitals, they undergo linear combination to form a set of bonding MO and antibonding MO. Bonding MO, BMO, is of lower energy, stable. Antibonding MO, ABMO, is of higher energy than the respective atomic orbitals. And now the presence of electrons in the bonding MO brings stability, bonding characteristics. And the presence of electrons in antibonding MO, ABMO, will reduce its bonding power or will destroy the bonding power. So if the number of electrons remaining in the BMOs is more than that remaining in ABMO, then such a species is stable, having net bonding characteristics. Now, let me tell you, in benzene, there are 6 pi electrons, 6 p orbitals, they combine linearly, LCAO, linear combination of atomic orbital approach, is applied to produce 6 MOs, out of which 3 are bonding MO, 3 are antibonding MO. This is the middle line of having energy of individual atomic orbitals. Antibonding MO are of higher energy, bonding MO are of lower energy. So all these 6 pi electrons are now filled in the MOs. The AOs are gone, they are perished. In their place, we have MOs, 6 MOs. This is pi 1, where all the positive lobes are on one side, negative lobes are on the opposite side. So there are 6 pairs of bonding interaction. This pair, this pair, this pair, this pair, this pair. 6 pairs of bonding interactions. So it is most stable, pi 1. And in these two, there will be 2 net bonding interaction. 4 pairs of bonding interaction and 2 pairs of antibonding interaction. So 4 minus 2, so there is 2 net pair of bonding interactions. I am showing you where these shaded ones are positive lobes and the unshaded ones are negative lobes with negative signs. So positive, positive, negative, negative. This is bonding interaction. One pair, second pair, two, third pair, fourth pair. So there are four bonding interaction and one antibonding here and one antibonding here. So 4 minus 2, so net 2 bonding interaction. Here also, you know, if I draw, this is another, these two MOs are degenerate. Degenerate means having same energy. I have cancelled this orbital because they have no net bonding power. Why? Because this is plus, this is minus. This is plus, this is minus. So this plus plus, they have bonding. And this plus minus, they will cancel bonding. So ultimately this one has no power of bonding or antibonding. Because one bonding, one antibonding, so the bonding power is lost. So similarly here, plus plus bonding, plus minus antibonding. That is the reason why we have removed these two orbitals, because they have lost any bonding power. So this is another MO where there is one nodal plane. Here there is no nodal plane because these are all delocalized orbitals, you know, there is, so you cannot have a plane passing through either between bonds or between atoms to get any nodal plane, vertical nodal plane. So there is no vertical nodal plane here, but here you will find one in each case. Here the nodal plane passes in between bonds, plus minus, there is no net bonding, plus minus, no net bonding. Here the nodal plane passes through atoms because this is lost. I mean this orbital as if it is non-existent. This orbital as if it is non-existent. So the nodal plane passes through the atoms. So these are the two degenerate MOs having identical energy, but they are bonding. Net bonding power is there. Right? So, and then these are the two antibonding orbitals of identical energy, degenerate antibonding MOs, pi 4, pi 5, pi 4 star, pi 5 star. This, each of them has two nodes, nodal planes, two vertical nodal planes. In this case, the two nodes passes in between bonds, and in this case, one passes in between atoms and the other passes in between bonds. And this I have removed because this orbital loses its bonding power, because this is plus plus bonding, plus minus antibonding, this cancel out. So this was minus, minus minus bonding, minus plus antibonding. So this is also cancelled out. But this is a different type of MO because the nodal planes are differently placed. That is why it is a different MO but having same energy, degenerate antibonding MO. And finally, there are three vertical nodal planes here, and all the three pass in between the bonds. Highest energy is pi 6 star. So out of the 6 electrons, according to Hund's rule and Aufbau's principle, 2 here, then 1, 1, 2, 2. Hund's rule have to be applied, 1, 1, 2, 2. So all these three are occupied and they are electron pairs. There is no unpaired electron to produce instability, and all of them produce or make a closed bonding cell. This is called closed bonding cell. That is why benzene is so very stable, because all the 6 electrons are paired. They remain in bonding MO having lower energy, not in antibonding MO, not even non-bonding MO, as we shall see in cyclobutadiene why they are unstable, why that is unstable and aromatic. Got it? I am not going to the details. Just for fun, I am discussing this. Same thing. Why I cancelled this, I have said. Why I have cancelled these two and here these two. Of course, I have written here. This one, in this picture, it is here. You will find the number of positive lobes upwards. Upper lobes positive is plus 3 and 3. But here the upper positive lobes is 4 and the upper negative lobes is 2. But still then the number of nodes is 1. You will find this will be cancelled out and it will be producing a node. So also in this case there will be 2 nodes. But the number of positive lobes and negative lobes lying above and below, they will be different, but still they will be having two nodes, and here there are three nodes. And the MO configuration, pi MO configuration, the 6 pi electrons is pi 1 2, pi 2 2, pi 3 2. So they are remaining well below the middle line in a lower energy level, and they are very stable. But in case of cyclobutadiene, which is anti-aromatic, what happens, you know, out of the 4 p orbitals which will go for LCAO to produce 4 MOs, pi 1 is bonding MO. All the positive lobes are above, all the negative lobes are below, so it is BMO. But the next level is not antibonding. Although it has got one node each, but still the MO has no net bonding power. Because this is one bonding, two bonding, and two antibonding. You see, two bonding and two antibonding. So they cancel out, no bonding, no antibonding. Similarly, here, you take it in a different way. If you cancel it out, then supposing you cancel these two out because this loses all bonding relationship. Because one bonding, one antibonding, so you can remove it. No bonding power. One bonding, one antibonding. You remove also this. So if you do that, that will give you another degenerate MO, where the placement of the node is through atoms, here in between bonds. Therefore, these two, although the orbitals look similar, plus plus minus minus plus plus minus minus, but still you find this is another MO having similar energy, right? So, and there are two nodes here, one, two nodes. This is a real ABMO, but this is not ABMO, not BMO. This is called non-bonding MO. Having same energy as if there is no bonding, no antibonding, that is similar to energy before combination, atomic orbitals. So out of the 4 pi electrons, 2 will remain in the BMO of lower energy, and the other 2 will remain, according to Hund's rule, 1-1 each, right? So, you know, the net bonding power, you know, of course, this is not antibonding, this is bonding. So there is net bonding power, no doubt. But the diradical, this is a diradical. And energy is not less, because in this case, clear cut, the bonding MOs carry the electron pairs. But in this case, the non-bonding MOs carry unpaired electrons. So the net energy of the system is more, and there are two unstable unpaired electrons. Because of that, according to Hund's rule, the non-bonding orbitals pi 2 and pi 3. This pi 4 is really antibonding. You can put a star here. But pi 2 and pi 3, you cannot put a star here because it is not antibonding. Its energy is not above the midpoint. That is the energy of the atomic orbitals. So the non-bonding, the non-bonding MOs, pi 2 and pi 3, are singly occupied according to Hund's rule. Hence, cyclobutadiene is a diradical and is extremely unstable. It undergoes dimerization very easily. So that is the way. But if you consider only butadiene, not cyclo, only butadiene as cyclic one, there is no, all the four remain in bonding. Psi 1, this is pi 1, pi 2, should not be psi. Anyway, copy pasted psi 1, psi 2, these are the pi BMOs, and these are the two antibonding MO star. We can put star here, antibonding MO. Because it is not a closed loop, all the, in this pi 1 or psi 1, all the positive lobes are above, all the negative lobes are below. This is one, and here is one node. Two positive lobes are above and two positive lobes are below. So that two bonding interaction and one antibonding interaction, that there is one net bonding interaction here. So there is a bonding power. In the case of cyclobutadiene, pi 2 and pi 3, they were degenerate, and you know, they do not have any bonding power or antibonding power. So that is why they are non-bonding. Here there is clear-cut bonding effect. But then two nodes, one bonding and two antibonding, so there is a net antibonding, unstable. And there are three nodes and having all the three antibonding interaction, one, two, three, all antibonding interaction, no bonding interaction. So that is why the four electrons are present paired in a paired way, not in an unpaired way. Hund's rule does not come into picture here, so it is stable. So butadiene is not unstable, but cyclobutadiene is stable. Now I'm showing you benzene is aromatic stable because this is the midline, the non-bonding atomic orbital line, where all the six electrons they occupy in the bonding MO, bonding BMO. Bonding MO means BMO. So this is pi 1 2, pi 2 2, pi 3 2. And in cyclobutadiene, pi 1 2, but pi 2 1, pi 3 1. These are non-bonding MO containing one unpaired electron according to Hund's rule. That finishes our program, and I have given some practice questions to indicate whether these species belong to aromatic type or anti-aromatic type, or non-aromatic type. You have to mention A for aromatic, AA for anti-aromatic, and NR, no reaction. I'm sorry, non-aromatic for NR. So let us just think for a moment. You think and I am answering. This is cyclopentadiene iodine. We have given all examples. So everything is there in the notes that I will provide in the description box. Cyclopentadiene, 6 pi electrons, aromatic. This is 4 pi electrons, anti-aromatic. This one lone pair is conjugating, the other non-conjugating, localized. So 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 pi electrons. This is aromatic, furan. This is cyclopentadienyliumion. This is only for fun, in pen and paper, but not actually it is produced. This is cyclopentadienyliumion, 4 pi electrons, is anti-aromatic. This, there are two hydrogen atoms here. This is cycloheptatriene, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And because this is sp3, this is out of the plane, and that makes cycloheptatriene as non-aromatic. Looking like aromatic, 6 pi electrons, but because of the non-planarity due to this portion, the ring conjugation, the loop conjugation is not possible. So it's non-aromatic. And this is looks like cyclooctatetraene. Looks like it is anti-aromatic, 8 pi electrons, but actually it is puckered. It is top-shaped. Remember that? To escape anti-aromaticity, it takes up the non-planar shape. So that is non-aromatic. This is cyclopropanilium ion or cyclopropanium ion, 2 pi electron, and it is stable at low temperature, but it is aromatic. This is aromatic. This, because there are two hydrogen atoms, this is sp3 hybridized. So although there are 4 pi electrons, even it is not anti-aromatic, it is non-aromatic. And here this is every carbon is having one hydrogen each, all. So this is c7h7 plus tropylium ion, which is hugely aromatic. This is naphthalene aromatic. This is pyridine aromatic. This lone pair is conjugating, but this is not conjugating. This is not conjugating. This is thiophene derivative. So this is aromatic. So 6 pi electron aromatic. This is cycloheptatriene iodine, 8 pi electrons, anti-aromatic. Planar, but 8. 8 pi electrons means anti-aromatic. This is pentalene. I have told you it is anti-aromatic. 8 pi electrons, anti-aromatic, stable only below minus 100 degree Celsius. But its dianion is aromatic, that is 10 pi electrons. This is 8 pi electrons. And this is quinoline, this is aromatic, because this lone pair is not included. This is delocalized, it is localized. So only this is 10 pi electrons makes it aromatic. Now, it's all gone. So answers I have already given, but when I give you the description box, I will remove all these answers. I have done it here. You do of your own and then try to match with my answers. How did you like it? If you liked it, following it, put a thumbs up and also subscribe. What's the harm in subscribing? We are not going to pay anything if you subscribe. Bye-bye. In the next video, we will be discussing about the orientation and reactivity in Benjamin Ring. Bye.